And of course, we continue with the rolling coverage after the passing of Archbishop Emeritus Desmond Tutu, and tributes are still pouring in from politicians and ordinary South Africans. eNCA reporter Monique Mortlock is in Cape Town for us, and she joins us now live. Monique, I believe you're with a special guest there today. You visited the home of a retired judge. What is he saying about the legacy of Desmond Tutu?
Yes, I'm in the home of retired High Court Judge Siraj Desai, and he's also a board member for the District 6 Museum. And as you mentioned, rightly so, we've been hearing tributes pouring in from politicians, religious leaders, organizations across South Africa and around the world. A little earlier when we were speaking to Premier Alan Windey, he was saying that one needs to remember the legacy that the Archbishop Emeritus Desmond Tutu has left behind, instead of just focusing on that sadness by South Africans on his passing. Thank you very much for joining us. Tell us, let's chat about the legacy that the Arch leaves behind.
Yes. Thank you very much, and good morning to your listeners. Let me say this, that I'm the current chair of the board of the District 6 Museum, and the Archbishop was a founder member and the patron of the museum. Over the years, in my capacity as chair and my tenure as chair, I had regular contact with him. He was there when the elders came to the museum. He was there when the Russell Tribunal was hosted by the museum. I've known him for almost half a century. But I also knew him in another capacity. In my early years in practice, I was employed by Dalla Omar down the road here in Woodstock. And Bishop was the, then a bishop, was now Archbishop, or was a regular visitor to the office because we were coordinating the defense of the people involved in the 1976 uprising. It's before you were born. But that period of unrest that he was actively involved in, and we actually coordinated with him the defense of all the people who were prosecuted. But you know, over and above all of that, my own experience of the bishop, he was the moral conscience of the country. Everybody says that. But it's important to note that he was, in fact, the conscience of the country, in the sense that he spoke truth to power, whether it was to the apartheid regime or with his post-94 democracy which failed. And he was over and above acutely aware of the failings of democracy. I recall a special moment in my own life when I was speaking at the gathering and the Archbishop was present. And I focused on the fact that in South Africa today, the greatest problem is inequality and the plight of the poor. And everybody was rather muted on the occasion. But the Archbishop came up to me and he slapped me on my shoulder and he said, "My boy, you're absolutely right." He was affirming what I said. He was himself acutely aware of the plight of the poor in this country. That's the sort of individual we are losing today. The individual who played an enormous role in the struggle years, who continued to play a role in post-94 in our democracy, and his legacy must be sustained for us to continue to live in his image. It's sad to note that this has passed on, but he leaves behind such an enormous legacy that we all live to it.
And I'm glad you mentioned the fact that he's been called the model compass or the model conscience of South Africa. As you said, it's something that we've heard from various leaders and politicians. Who do we have now? Do you think there's still hope in South Africa? We have leaders like yourself. We have anti-apartheid stalwarts who we've lost over the years. Who do we have now to be that model compass in South Africa?
Yes. He was a moral compass in many different senses, but he was a moral compass also in the sense that he rose above ordinary party politics. He stood for justice. He stood on the side of the poor. And those two cardinal principles of his life cannot be challenged. There are many people. In any situation, a country throws up its own leaders, and we will throw up our future archbishops and our lawyers of the future. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And just lastly, your message to the family, to the Tutu family.
Yes. And I extend my deepest condolences to Madam Leah Tutu and Bishop Tutu, Archbishop Tutu's children. You can rest assured that we will remember him and we are with you at this time of crisis in your lives.
Thank you very much. Former Judge Siraj Desai sharing some beautiful memories of his own with the Archbishop Emeritus Desmond Tutu, saying there that although we've lost one of South Africa's great model compasses, that there will surely be many more, and that there are still surely many more that will carry on with the Arch's legacy.